Welcome, everyone. We'll have a talk by Claudia about Python and rock and roll. Please welcome Claudia.
Well, thank you, everybody, for coming. My name is Claudia. I am working as a data scientist at Kernel Analytics. You can find me at Twitter as Claudia Guirao. By the way, we are hiring, so in case you are interested in joining us, please contact me after. Well, I'm talking today about a personal project. It is born where data science and rock music and Python joins. It is mainly about satisfying my curiosity. I'm a rocker, I love rock music, and I was asking myself if I could do something to know more about a passion. Because of, I know some of you were yesterday at party and laughing and rocking. I will reference some good talks and excellent speakers during this week. They explain very good, better than me, NLP, database, and some music talks. And also, in case you miss the keynote of today, you should take a look after, because Gail explained my topic so much better than I could do. So please review it, and it is quite interesting. So the main development stages were these four: data graphing and storage, data processing and term frequency, clustering and topic modeling, and the future steps. First one is data graphing. As I said, it is about rock, about lyrics and NLP. And there are two ways to get the data: live scrapping, go to concert, have fun. And another way, faster but less fun, is web scrapping. All the dataset were scraped from MLDB using request and beautiful soup. But in case you are going to make this massively, you should take a look to Scrappy. Used for my convenience, I storage all the data in MongoDB. This is me working hard for this talk in the Patti Smith concert. And I have to make two disclaimers. The first one is that all groups were selected considering my personal preferences. In case you want to add another one, contact me and I will do it. And the second one is a legal disclaimer. Lyrics has copyright, so manage with care. I cannot publicly share the data set. Maybe some engrams, but it is illegal stuff. Well, this is more or less how it looks like in its raw version. I have the group, the album, the song, the website, and also the raw lyrics. I have scrapped more than 7,000 songs from more than 50 groups. This is in case you are not used to work with MongoDB, it is only a group by query, by group. So we have the top 10 groups spread, or the more productive groups, by the number of songs. And I have a nice snake with the frequency of it. Well, next step is the data processing. We have to clean the lyrics and avoid the meaningless word, avoid the punctuation. And if you take a look, I have to add to the regular stop words, the stop words in music. It is full of da-da-da, la-la-la, and that kind of stuff, and I had to clean it. Perhaps I forgot someone. Also, we have the English contractions. And what I have done is process the raw lyrics and store it in another collection. It is called Cool Groups Process. Well, once I have the cleaner data set, what I have done is start satisfying my curiosity. The first thing I did was compare the my corpus, the lyrics, the songs, with the Brown corpus. In case you don't know what it is a collection of documents done in the 60s. And it is a compiled with different fields of documents. Unfortunately, it doesn't contain lyrics, so it's regular. So what I did is to take into account the term frequency in my lyrics and the third frequency in the Brown corpus, and with the previously formula, get the rockness index. And not surprisingly, those are the 10 most rocking words. Hey, goodbye, babe, baby, tonight. So everything is going okay. And those are the not rocking words. However, general, schools, military. I still want to play with term frequencies, and if you consider the full corpus, I'm sorry. If you consider the full corpus, the most frequent word is love. And once again, if you plot it, and if you plot it from the my favorite groups, maybe, love is one of the most in Queen. Is one of the most frequent, or the most frequent in the Beatles, also in David Bowie, but not in Nirvana. Another question came to my mind after this analysis. Have raw lyrics and extensive vocabulary? What I did is take into account the length of the unique words in each group. And considering grouping by the band, the most rich lyrics group is Bob Dylan and Bruce Springsteen. And the less ones, Motorhead, AC/DC. So I did the same by the other grouping by song and considering the mean. And you have that surprisingly Rage Against the Machine has an average of 93 words by song. It is rare, but considering that Bob Dylan and Patti Smith are almost poeticians, it is not strange that they have more than the average words per song. And on the flops, we have Radiohead, because they don't have so much lyrics, Nirvana, and the Beatles. They sound fun, but they didn't actually use so much words in its own. Last question was, is rock about sex and drugs? If we ask about songs with love, kiss, and sex in its lyrics, we have 1,700, more than 1,700 songs. It is almost the 20% of the songs are talking about love, but if we ask the same about drugs, only 24 songs are talking about or have the word drugs in it. So I prefer to change that sentence by this one: peace, love, and rock. By this point, we already know that grouping by band only let us a few documents. Rock has not an extensive vocabulary, what disappoints me a bit. And also we have the intuition that rock songs are always talking about the same. The same words, there are not so much difference between groups and not so much difference between songs. However, I didn't surrender and I tried to make some more sophisticated techniques, and I prepare my data set. This is what Gail explained this morning. I actually tokenize and stem the word, get the data, prepare it, and as I said, we have only 100,000, or more than 100,000 words in our vocabulary, with that is a small vocabulary. And what we do next is The time frequency inverse document frequency algorithm, it is it's classical definitions by formulas, but what we have to take into account is that these algorithms allows us to get the most relevant words in our songs or groups. In this case, we do the feature extraction with scikit-learn. I'm going so fast because you already have this presentation and I don't have so much time to explain the algorithm. And we already have a matrix with the similarity into the groups. And we are ready to clustering. What I'm going to do is k-means. I try with three clusters. But unfortunately, what we have at the algorithm is something like that. Three groups and some words that are not so meaningful. I cannot title this cluster. I cannot title also this one. And the groups are not so... If I did it by hand, I didn't put these groups together. But if we take a look at the plot, next slide. I know it's small, but if you can see, the closer groups are the most similar, and it makes a little bit more sense. Bob Dylan and Bruce Springsteen are near, also David Bowie, and The Who and Pulp and Blur are also in the same or closed, but we cannot see clearly any cluster. The main conclusion is, by this algorithm, we cannot cluster or group our rock bands. It is because, as I said, they are so similar. Once again, I didn't surrender. I tried another technique. I did an hierarchical clustering, and when you plot it, also you cannot see any cluster in the groups. And I was so sad about it. Once again, I will try another technique. It is LDA. For those who are not into NLP, I will make an easy explanation of that. If you take a look at these five sentences, it is obvious that the first and the second one are talking about food. The third and the fourth are about pets or animals, and the last one is a mix of the previously topics. This is what LDA does. I did the same with my songs, not grouping by rock band. And what I get, I did 10 topics model, and what I get looks like that. Once again, there's not so much meaning. It is ambiguous, and I don't have an answer about topics looking at this. So I move forward, and I try another more complicated technique, word to back. I don't have so much time to explain it, but by approximation, what I have after the algorithm is the words closer to one in the corpus. So love. Oh, these words are close to love, making love, tender love, true love, avoiding love. And if we try the same with riot, we have guerrilla and psycho and hooligan. Well, this is going a little bit better than the previously. And by the way, as I promised in my summary, we are going to talk about the David Bowie evolution. I know everyone loves the graphs and the plots, and also I. What I did is take into account the main, the most frequent words in the discography of David Bowie, grouping by album, and sorted by the release album, the date of the release. And if you take a look, the blue dots are sorry, the blue, dark blue dots are love words. And you can see in these albums, they are not so frequent. Maybe Bowie was sad or not so in love. And in this album, he doesn't speak so much about it. But in this one, Never Let Me Down, he repeated this word more than 25 times. As a bonus track, I have the Queen Evolution, a group actually I love. I did the same, but with these four words, love, time, want, and know. And I plot it. And Queen is always about love, except in the first two albums. Hope you can see it. If not, you already have it online. But in the Queen and Queen 2, it's not so much repeated, but in the middle of the discography, they repeated more than 80 times in an album. It's so much. Well, what's next? I did this project in less than 1 month. It is by pleasure, and what I would like to do next is do it massively, scrap more groups and more styles, and try to make some clusters that actually works, include some patterns, and my final objective will be made an hybrid recommender system. So, of course, for get this thing done, I need some help, so feel free to collaborate with me. The notebook will be at GitHub, and the PDF of this presentation is already online. You could check it. And also, thank you for your attention. Keep rocking it. See you at PyConnect this autumn.
Thank you, Claudia. So we have time for questions.
Yes. Sorry. Hi, Claudia. Thank you for your talk. It was really amazing. I was wondering, like, Pulp in Blur, wasn't it, who were together? Okay, so do you think that maybe there's an American and English language affecting, like, some words maybe are closest because the dialect?
Could be.
Thank you.
Probably. Actually, there are more British group than American in my corpus. Maybe that is affecting my study, but probably they are using the same words. So thank you.
Thank you.
Other questions?
Oh. Hi, thank you for your talk. You said that groups were most times very similar. Isn't that because you only took groups you like?
Yeah, probably. Probably. Well, I think 15 groups is not a few. I think it's quite big, but probably they are so similar because I choose it. I like the same groups and I found it through the history. So, but mainly they are about 80s, and probably it is affecting. If I take some more nowadays groups, probably it changes.
Thank you.
Well, I don't know anything about natural language processing, so maybe this is a stupid question. But do you think, like, aggregating a lot of more lyrics and trying to tag manually some of them so you can help the algorithm will help, like, finding more clusters or finding more relationships between words and stuff like that?
Well, if I add more lyrics.
Yeah, if you add more lyrics, and also if you tag manually, okay, so this song is about love, a friendship and whatever.
It was really hard to make. Probably it will help if we to make another, to use another classifying algorithm that I'm not using because I don't have a target, actually. If I had tags or something like that, I could make it.
Thank you for the talk. Drugs. Have you thought about euphemisms? I'm thinking like drugs and sex are things we don't normally talk and like in songs don't express in those words. So I'm not surprised you haven't found a high count of like the word drugs. But I'm not a native speaker, but I'm sure there's suggestions of like how we talk about drugs. Yeah. Have you looked at them?
Yeah, actually, I didn't want to put explicitly so much words in that field in drugs. Probably they are not using explicitly the word drugs, also not the chemically substance. So maybe they are using synonyms, but I'm not English, obviously, native, so I don't know how to put it in the query.
Thank you for your attention, and thank you, Claudia, again.